Alright, what is up, guys? This is absolutely insane. I did not think this would be happening. So, my uncle just showed up a few hours ago with tons and tons and tons of pennies. And when I say tons and tons and tons, I mean tons and tons and tons. And I am planning on doing a series for my first part of my YouTube channel. And I think this is going to be absolutely amazing. So, I am super pumped, I hope you are, and I will see you when we start the hunt. Alright, I have just started the hunt, and this is unbelievable. We already have finds. I cannot believe this. So, find number one out of two is a 1953 wheat penny. And find number two is a 1914. Unbelievable, guys. Right out on the first grab. Crazy. Alright guys, grab number two has a red-brown wheat scent. It is 1950. There we go. Really nice shape. Decent date to have. But an early good find. Very nice. Alright, number three. Grab number three has two finds. A dime from, let's get this date, 1965, I think. Let me get that focused. Anyways, I don't know how well you can see that, but yep, there it is, 65. It is 1 year off from silver. Silver would have been great, but it's not. Next, we have a 1966 Canadian. It looks like it came out of a house fire. You can tell because of that darker kind of toning to it almost. But that is a foreign. We'll take those. Grab number four, and we have a 1954 Denver wheat scent. Another wheat scent on the board. Very nice. Number five, grab number five, and we have a 1959 penny. It is not a wheat, but it is close. It's 1 year off, and I collect them anyways. So I'm really sorry I can't get this focused. Anyways, take my word for it. 1959. There we go. Yeah, now you can see. 1959. Not a wheat scent, but I'll take it. Alright guys, grab number six, and we have one find. It is a better looking red-brown 1959. Here's an up close look at that. You can see the red luster. It is of course not a mule scent. But there it is. Alright, so we are on grab number seven, and we have two finds. First find is a 1947 wheat penny. Nothing special, no extra luster, but it's a wheat. Find number two is another 1959 Philadelphia. Okay, so we are on grab number 8 out of 10 for this video, and we have one wheat scent. This wheat scent is, I believe, looks 40s, 45, yep. Not bad, we'll take it. Alright, this is heating up. We have two finds in grab number 9, one of which is a 45 wheat scent. Another one. Little bit of weird nicking on that edge. Up at the top, but we can work with that. And then we have a 44. If it had a mint mark, I could check for the D over S or S over D, but we do not have that. Just Philly. Just fine. Alright, well, we have finished our hunting for this video, so I will give you the wrap up now. So, what we have is some 40s Wheaties right here. Let me get the lighting right. Here we go. Alright. So about that. 40 Sweeties, 44, 2 1945s, 2 1947s, a beautiful 1950, love that coin, a 1953 Philly, a 1954 Denver, a 1958 Philly, and 3 1959s, including the beautiful one in the middle. We also have a 1914 Wee Penny, which I think is amazing. I did not expect to get that out of this collection. We have a 1966 Canadian and a 1965 Dime. Alright, thank you so much for watching. Please like the video and subscribe to see the rest of the series, and I will see you on the second episode of the series where we do grabs number 11 through 20. I will see you there. Thanks for watching.